गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आवर सेकंड चैप्टर ऑफ सिविक्स, डाइवर्सिटी एंड डिस्क्रिमिनेशन। इन द प्रीवियस चैप्टर वी डिस्कस अबाउट द डिफरेंट एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ डाइवर्सिटी। देन व्हाट इज डाइवर्सिटी? डाइवर्सिटी मीन्स व्हेन देयर आर डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ पीपल, डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ पीपल हु बिलोंग्स टू डिफरेंट रिलीजन एंड कास्ट, ऑल लिविंग इन द सेम प्लेस इज कॉल्ड डाइवर्सिटी। सो दैट्स व्हाई वी ऑलवेज कॉल आवर इंडिया अ डाइवर्स कंट्री। In India, there are different type of people who belong to different religions, who used to speak different languages, have different food habits. So these all come under the diversity. So this chapter is based on the diversity and discrimination. So what is diversity? Geographical and historical factors encourage diversity in India. We have earlier in the last chapter, we discussed about the different geographical and historical factors about Ladakh and Kerala, in which we came to know that geographical and historical factors both play a very important role when we want to discuss about the diverse characteristics of any two states. So, diversity is encouraged by the geographical and historical factors. So, these two factors are very important when we are discussing about diversity. Right, then diversity is diversity gave us strength as well as weakness. If we are able to understand the positive aspects of diversity, we call it our strength. But when we are talking about diversity in a negative opinion, when we are unable to understand different aspects, we call our diversity a weakness. For example, in the last chapter we discussed that during the time of freedom struggle, our India shows that diversity is not a weakness. Diversity is a strength, because at the time of a struggle, millions of people, thousands of people came together. Either they belong to Muslim community, they belong to Hindu community, they all work together so that our India get independence. At that time, diversity came under the category of strength, not a weakness. But sometime when we are unable to understand that the different factors also helpful for us, and we are unable to understand the importance of it, then diversity came under the category of weakness. So when the diversity came under the concept of a weakness, we call it a discrimination. When we make negative opinion about people without understanding why they are different from us, when we are unable to understand this concept that why they are different from us, our diversity came under the negative opinion. So when a diversity came under a negative opinion, it become discrimination. So this is the basic idea behind starting this chapter, diversity and discrimination. So diversity came under a positive aspect, but on the other hand, when we talk about diversity in a negative concept, we talk it as a discrimination. Yes, so the other term which we use for the discrimination is prejudice. So what is prejudice? Prejudice means when we judge other people negatively or see them as inferior without knowing them. As we don't have a complete information about a particular group of citizens, we may create a negative opinion about them. So that negative opinion is called prejudice. These things happen mainly in the urban areas where, when any one person came from a small town, it become very difficult for that person to adjust in a modern area. So at that time, those who already are living in a modern area, they started making a negative opinion about that person who came from a small town. So prejudice mainly shows us, prejudice is a sign of narrow-mindedness, injustice and unfairness. So prejudice and discrimination both are the same things, but the word which we used or which we prefer to illustrate the fact that the thinking of other, the negative thinking of other people for a person who belongs to other religion or maybe he come from a small town. So the word which we use here is prejudice. So prejudice basically is a sign of narrow-mindedness, unfairness or injustice. And when we talk about discrimination means treating people differently or negatively on the grounds of age, religion, disability, gender or income. So this come under discrimination. For example, we have seen that in many schools in village area where a student came from a Dalit community, so there become a discrimination among that student that if he belongs to a Dalit community, he is not supposed to sit with the other students in the class. So this is a discrimination, and the ground of discrimination here is the caste. He belongs to a minority caste, that's why he is not supposed to sit with the other students in the class. So prejudice come when we judge people, when we have a judging capability of people that he belongs to, comes from a small town. But when we talk about the discrimination, use the terms for comparison in different age, different religion, disability, gender, and income. So there is a difference, very minor difference between discrimination and prejudice.